So we after the concert, my friend and my actually were just talking. I'm like, we really have to pray. Like, I feel something strange about her. Like, I don't know what it is, but we just really have to pray. And I feel like God wants to take us higher. This time I was like, God, I want to be sure right now that yes, that right. I know you, and I'm getting baptized. That was all I was telling my friend with me. Like, but where did God say he's going to send the messenger? Like, why is it that we're all seeing different things? Like, I can't even tell someone, you know, okay, I'm Christian, and I expect that if like we can all say the same thing. Like, why are we saying different things? And we all call ourselves Christians. We all hide under the umbrella that we're Christians. Like, why all this? And now, where did God say he's going to send the messenger? So before then, John had put something up on the RCF page. I didn't. It was
Jean.
Yeah. It was totally oblivious to me. And I knew that Jean was like coming once in a while. Mm-hmm. And at this time, we had the fellowship, and it was like, people, we need to know the times we're in. I had no idea what he was talking about. Okay. Like, when I remember it now, I just laugh. But so he put something on Facebook about Christmas, and my friend had seen that, and so before then too, like, right. she was having this fellowship with Tash and Jean, and she has always been telling me that she was not comfortable with Jean. So for some reason I wasn't taking what she was saying serious. Like, I don't know, she was just like, and I didn't know what she was talking about.
Right,
and
right.
I didn't feel like, I don't know, there was nothing in me taking it serious. So I was just like, okay, it's fine. So that sometimes we go pray, and there was a time that she left them and stuff like that, but she was talking, and I'm like, I don't know, like, I was listening to her, like, yeah,
okay,
nice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But nothing. And Tash seemed very comfortable with it. Like, she was like, oh, God is saying something, like, okay.
Yes,
nice. So that day when she told me about the Christmas stuff, when we finally read what he wrote on Facebook, even when she read it again with me, like, she didn't find anything. She was like, oh, it wasn't as I thought. I just said, yeah, like, it's not that bad. But I didn't say anything, but I said in my heart, I'm like, but wait, why did Lillian, Jumai, and Steve not come to church today? Is it because of what he put on Facebook? Mm-hmm. Like, I hope that was not the reason why I didn't go to church, right? So I had this misconception in my heart by then, because of that, actually.
Okay.
So when we went and I came back home, the next day, Jean and Stephen came and started talking to us about a messenger. So while he was talking, I'm looking at him like, are you Mormon? Are you Mormon? Say it's Mormon. Like, so, like, I was just waiting for him to say he was Mormon. So I'm like, is he Mormon? Like,
yeah.
He should be Mormon. I heard messenger yesterday. Like, so he was actually, what he was saying was correct. Like, I haven't seen that before. Like,
okay,
all my years of being in a Christian family and hearing so many messages and everything, I haven't heard that before, but I just felt he was Mormon because he was talking about a messenger. So I'm like, okay. So I sat. But one thing that really struck me was when he said Revelation 3:20, and Christ was standing outside the door knocking. I'm like, ooh, outside the door of the church, the systems, not my heart, the church.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh. So that evening, so after everything, Lillian and Jumai had to leave. And they were listening to a message. I slept off, and later I went inside. And when my friend came later on, I told her, I'm like, could it be that what we're used to is wrong?
It's a bigger thought.
Yeah, so I was like, could it be so? And before then, Stephen used to say, the glory of God had departed from the church. Now, he had not known the message by this time. I don't know where he got that from. But I believe when he said that the glory of God had died for each other. Because I feel like if you look at the Bible and you look at now, like, something's not right. I'm like, probably the glory of God had died from the church. I don't know why I believe that, actually. But looking at it now, I'm like, wait, if the glory of God had died for each other, why even going there? Like, it's a big statement, right?
Yeah.
But for some reason, I was just like, could it be that what we're doing is wrong? She didn't say anything, but we went to pray that night, and they were coming now. They were coming every day, talking about this thing. It was really, really annoying me. So I was just waiting for them to be like.
So you're in the same room with Lillian and yes, Jemai. So yes. They're coming over to your apartment.
Exactly. Speaking about this message.
Yeah.
And I was just there listening to them. And at some point I was like, I don't know. Like I had so many questions, but I wasn't asking them. So I was just keeping them in my heart.
Okay.
So the day Precious was around and through Skype, and she was asking my questions, like, yes, thank you very much, thank you. So I started jotting like the answers they were giving, and like, so I was like, okay, so wait, does it mean that, but they thought I was busy with my laptop, maybe browsing Facebook or something that day, but I was typing like what they were saying, like, so does it mean, wait, but is that scripture not referring to John the Baptist? So wait,
right.
Like, there were so many questions in my jotting, so like, okay, it's fine. So, someone came they came again talking about the message again, and someone was like, do you mean all these preachers? I'm like, So I was just laughing because I had not considered other preachers at then. So it was like, oh yeah, other preachers, that's true. But you know, so they were talking and everything, and he was like, why blood, why baptism in the name of Jesus? I know that I had known before then that Jesus, like, God is not God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, like, he's one, right? But it's like, I didn't understand why diffuse, like why making it a big issue, like have our disagreements,
yeah.
Like, and so like just like, because even before then when we were doing like a class in the church we used to go to,
mm-hmm.
they were looking at Cain and Abel, and because I had heard something from one other preacher I used to listen to, I'm like, you know, Abel gave a better offering by revelation, not by.
Right.
Not because, like, notice, like, people hardly bring crops to God as offering. Like, it's always blood. Like,
mm-hmm.
That's why God receives his. So I said that, and someone countered it, and they all countered it there, that, you know, like, he gave the first of the flock, and it's like, but it didn't change my mind. Like, that's one thing with me. Like,
okay.
Like, it's like, if you can say something, and I might be like, it didn't just touch me. Like,
yeah.
I'm just like, no, let's not go into any argument, right? So, so when he said that, there was, I think after some fellowship, when he said that, I was like, that's true. Like, yes, it was by revelation. So I don't know if I was like, yeah, that's really true.
Right.
But I didn't understand like why, okay, so yeah, it's supposed to be, so it's supposed to be that way. So yes, like, what then, like, why is it a big issue and all that, right? So they would talk about denomination, and I'm like, I don't know, and I didn't even know, like, I know that there's Pentecostal, there's Anglican, there's this, there's that. I just didn't feel comfortable with other ones. I just felt comfortable with Pentecostal.
Okay.
So I didn't understand like what denomination was or anything. But after, like, you know, after everything, so there was one, like, we're now planning for RCF, and John came and he was talking about all these things, and I'm like, what is this? So I told my friend, like, see, the way RCF is right now, like the fellowship we had,
mm-hmm.
like, this is not a good time for us to handle it. Like, the church better come and handle it, because we're not in unity at all. So she called the pastor, and they came the next day, and it was just funny. So now I wanted them to come, but I didn't just feel comfortable with it. So we got home that day, and Stephen was so upset, and like, was like, okay, that like he's going to step down from RCF.
Okay.
I with Juma and Lillian was angry with the way everything went that day, but I was like, no, don't step down. Like, I really meant it, like, no, like, let it be that, okay, they told you to leave, then you just step. I don't know why I gave him that advice, because actually I wanted him to stop talking. But I just told him, you know, just don't step down. Let it be that they tell you to leave and all that. Then you just step down and don't worry. I was like, God will strengthen you. Like, I don't know. Like, I was like, God will strengthen you. It's fine. Like, I genuinely, I wasn't faking it. I genuinely told him that, right? And then the next week, like, he was told to step down. I was then angry at the church. Like, why do you have to do that? So even the previous week when John came and like talking about like how everything went and all that. I had to apologize to them, like, oh, I'm sorry. Like, I thought we were going to start talking about this message in IWCF, and I felt like, why what's the need if we have different tables and I'm saying something different, Juma is saying something different, Lee is saying something different, Steven is saying something different, John is saying something different. Yeah. Like, it's not good. Like, we're supposed to be saying one thing, right? Mm-hmm. So, like, so I apologize to them. But so church have heard of it by then, not through me though. I don't know how they heard of it, but they heard of it, and so they started preaching about wrong doctrine. And so when they started talking about the East Slippery Serpent, I was like, oh yeah, I've heard that before. Oh, that's true. But for some reason, I wasn't questioning Eve sleeping with the serpent. Like, I just felt like, you know, God talks in parables, so anything is possible. Like, that's not the question, right? Like, it might be possible.
Yeah.
This was so shocking to me because I don't know how I went from no, that's wrong
right,
doctrine
right,
to,
right, to
no, God speaks in parables, so you know, yeah, his ways are yeah, past finding out.
Yeah.
So church was against it, and so many things now going on, and I was even in a prayer meeting one day and the pastor talked about it, and I felt so bad because we just normally have this little fellowship, not just to encourage ourselves, mm-hmm, right? And now it's known for deception. So that made me feel bad. Like, I don't like having a bad name. So
okay.
I was like what is all this? So I felt bad, but they were always coming out talking about the message. And I was tired of hearing about it.
You're tired of it?
Yeah, I was really tired. Like, but I didn't say anything, so I would just keep quiet and just look at them. But my expression should make them know that seriously.
It's
done.
You've done that to hear.
Yeah.
Has Stephen been put out now? Is he gone?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So he was. Well, he would come to church sometime, and they would still talk about the mess. Like, even though he, like, the times he was like, okay, like, I don't want to talk about his message again, da, 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 da. I felt happy, like, yeah, nice, don't talk about it again, you know?
Right.
But he would still come and still talk about it, I'm like, okay, seriously. So, I listened to what they say, mm-hmm, and I remember things.
Okay.
So, when some people talk about some things, I know the reply Stephen will give.
Okay.
And so when he gives a reply, I'm like, I told you, like, that's what he would give, right? But I didn't know the message, and at a point I'm like, I don't understand why they are so passionate about this. Like,
okay,
I didn't even understand the difference, first of all, because some of the things they were saying, I believe that too, but like, if I didn't even know my church did not believe that. And even though I knew they didn't believe that, I didn't see it as a problem. Like,
okay,
that was just like, my
get over
yeah
it.
Like, it's like, oh, they don't believe it. Oh, okay. Like, I didn't see it as, because I felt then God was like teaching me about like the Holy Spirit is Jesus and Jesus is God, and God, like, it was just marveling to me, like, okay, wait, so Jesus is living in me, the Holy Spirit is in me, and
mm-hmm,
God, like, so which is in me, like,
yeah,
it has to be God. Like, it's God is God, right? But when I was having a discussion once with one of the pastors in church, and he was like, you know, Holy Spirit is the third person of the Trinity. I'm like, what's that? Like, I didn't even understand that. So, yes, we had, but I didn't just feel like it's something to, let them have their opinions. That was how I used to be there. But I didn't know that the religious systems are also going to bring themselves as well. Where's the impact? Like, he just went there, made some noise, and he came back like, no, nothing. I think this thing is really serious before God.